Day four gets underway here at the 28th Summer University Games in Gwangju, Korea. There, a look at the main press center here in Gwangju. But in these highlights, we'll jump back to last night, the men's and women's individual all-around in gymnastics competition. We'll then head to the court as Korea took on China in Group A men's basketball. We'll also look in on rowing, including one very close race in men's pairs. And in swimming, the men's 400 meters and the women's 100 meter freestyle. And then from today, archery competition, the men's and women's team, and also men's 25 meter pistol. We go back to last night for artistic gymnastics, the individual all around, both men and women. We'll start with the men. And here's Akash Modi of the United States on the pommel horse. He was a bronze medalist in this apparatus at the U.S. College Championships earlier this year. Also won team and individual all-around silver medals there. There you see his dismount. Good performance there for Modi. He's happy with that one. And he'll score 14.633. Move on now to Shogo Nonomura of Japan on the rings. He was a member of Japan's gold medal in the team all-around competition earlier this week. He was also part of Japan's all-around bronze medal at Kazan in 2013. And a solid dismount there for Nonomura. Japanese fans loving that. He'll score 15.025. And now Oleg Vernayev on the parallel bars. He is the defending world champion and two-time defending European champion on this apparatus. Also won the individual all-around at this year's Europeans. He won a bronze medal earlier this week in the team all-around. Scores 15.900. He had a good slow motion view of his dismount there. Sticks it perfectly. And he loves it. That will help propel him to a gold medal in the men's individual all-around. Shogo Nonomura wins silver, and Akash Modi will claim the bronze. Moving on now to the women's individual all-around. Here is Asuka Teramoto of Japan. She was part of Japan's silver medal winning team in the all-around competition earlier here at Gwangju. She narrowly missed out winning a bronze medal in last year's World Championships, placing fourth. A little bit of a hop on the dismount there, but a solid performance for her.
Judges, march in.
And now Kelly Sim of the United Kingdom. Here she is on the uneven bars. Member of the England team that won the all-around gold at last year's Commonwealth Games in Glasgow, Scotland, and was fifth in this discipline earlier this year in the English Championships. Gets ready for her dismount. Perfect landing, no step at all. Beautiful performance there for Sim. You get a good look at the complexity of this apparatus. And a good shot of the dismount. For Sim, a gold medal, the total of 56.332. Two Japanese competitors, Teramoto and Sasada, will take silver and bronze respectively. From last night at the Dongkang College Gymnasium, it is Group A men's basketball action. Home favorites Korea taking on China. We get rolling here, Zhao to Guo, that's a miss. Korea will push the ball back up the other way. This is Lee Jae-do, he'll find Park. That one won't fall, but it's tipped home by Kang. Now for China, there is Chen. He goes hard to the hole, but it won't fall. Lee will find Ho Eun. He'll knock down the three-pointer. And Korea now up by eight. Korea now up 13. Out-rebounding China 14-6 in the early going. Choi into traffic. And he'll finish that one strong. Now China later here in the second quarter, now only down by six. They'll work it over to Gu. That one, he'll bank in. China within three. There you see Korean coach Lee Min-hyun looking on. Late again here in the second quarter. Ho will miss, almost gets the steal, but China will push it back the other way. And again, they'll find Gu. This time, he'll knock that one straight in. 33-30, Korea leads. Into the third quarter, there's a great steal by Korea's Ho, and he'll finish it off. We get a nice replay here, good anticipation, and then a great burst of speed to get up the floor, and he'll finish that one off easily. Korea back up 13 now. Lee will just wait there for Go to fly by and then calmly knock down the three-pointer. Korea in command now. Lee Jae-do will find Lee Dong-yup, but he can't finish. China pushes it back the other way. Wang will be fouled, but he'll hit the shot anyway and head to the line. China trying to stay in it. You get a good replay of that reverse layup. Korea, though, up 12. Nice take there. Kang tips home the initial shot from Lee Seung-hyun. And as time ticks down, Korea up by 10. They'll get the extra little layup here. And a bit of a strange play at the end as time is just about to expire. Chinese player hands to the Korean. He finishes it off. Man Hui Won with that extra deuce. And it all adds up to a 76-62 Korea win. Their first game of the tournament, they're 1-0. China falls to 1-2. From yesterday at the Chengdu Tangium Lake, outside of Gwangju, it is rowing competition. We'll start with the women's coxless fours. Features the crew from Ukraine in lane three that were fifth at last year's European Championships. Natalia Dovgodko on that crew. She was a gold medalist in the women's fours at the London 2012 Olympics. And there you see the Ukrainians well out in front. Germany looks comfortable there in second spot. And the Ukrainians will cross in a time of 6 minutes, 36.27 seconds to win a gold medal. Germany will take silver, and the Netherlands will slide into third spot for the bronze. There you see the Ukrainians happy with that gold medal win. And there are the medalists, Ukraine, Germany, and the Netherlands. Next up, the men's coxless pairs.
USA.
In lane three, the Hungarian crew, they were fifth at the 2015 European Championships. Bella Simone competed at the 2012 Olympics for Hungary. And they're in lane four right now. Just ahead is the Italian crew of Ferrarese and Ustolen. And it'll be a battle right to the wire. Hungary pushing just in front, and they will take the gold medal away from Italy. It'll be Adrian Juhasz and Bella Simone of Hungary winning gold. Italy wins silver. And Jort Timmer and Jimmer Smits of the Netherlands will win the bronze medal. And there you see the six medalists here from the men's pairs. Competition from yesterday at swimming, the Nambu University Aquatic Center. The women's 100 meter freestyle. This features two favorite Americans. In lane three, Shannon Vreeland. She already has a gold as part of the 4x100 meter freestyle relay team here in Korea. She also won gold in the London Olympics in the 4x200-meter freestyle relay. And then in lane three, Abby Weitzel of the U.S., she also won gold earlier this week on that 4x100-meter relay team. But out in front right now in lane four is Rosalia Nastudinova of Russia. And she'll come to the wall first as we head to the final 50 meters. Weitzel in second, Nastudinova of Russia in third. We get a good overhead look at how tight this race is. And now you see Vreeland there moving in front of Nastudinova, who seems to be running out of gas. Shannon Vreeland with a strong final push. And it will be Vreeland in gold medal position. Abby Weitzel of the U.S. in second. And Amy Matsuo of Japan will win the bronze medal. Nastudinova fell to seventh place.
Ladies and gentlemen, this concludes the medal awarding ceremony.
And in between, a little bit of dance action never hurt anybody either. Now the men's 400-meter freestyle. You see there in lane four, Jay Lelliott of Great Britain. He won a silver in the 800-meter freestyle earlier this week and also broke an English record in doing so. But it's neck and neck right to the wall here between Lelliott and Jack McLaughlin of Australia. And Lelliott touches just ahead in a time of 3 minutes, 48.84 seconds. Lelliott just ahead by 4/100ths of a second over McLaughlin, who will take the silver medal. Reed Malone will win bronze. He won gold earlier in the night in the 200-meter freestyle. And there you see a close-up of Lelliott, quite excited. There are the medalists, Lelliott, McLaughlin, and Malone. In today's action from archery at the Gwangju International Archery Center, it's the men's compound team final. This is the gold medal match featuring Korea and Mexico. Here you have the Korean team of Kim Jong-ho, Kim Tae-yoon, and Yang Young-ho. And for Mexico, it's Adolfo Medina, Mario Cardoso, and Daniel Del Valle Castillo. Here now in the fourth end, Korea leading. This Korean team won gold at last year's FISU World University Archery Championships held in Legnica, Poland. And Mexico a little frustrated there. Madeira and Del Valle Castillo were part of a team that won the Copa Juan Enrique Barrios event in 2014. Mexico did lead after the first end, 59-57, and again by one after three ends. So Korea looking to take over here in the fourth. The Korean team set a Universiad record in the ranking round. And again, a little bit of frustration on the face of the Mexicans. There's a score of nine. They can't get those tens that they need to keep pace with Korea, who scored 58 here in this fourth end. And Mexico won't be able to catch up. Korea will win a gold medal in the men's compound team final. It's close, 230 to 229 over Mexico. Italy wins a bronze medal. Now in the women's compound team final, this gold medal match features the United States and Russia. There you see the Russian team, Natalia Avdeeva, Maria Vinogradova, and Svetlana Cherkashineva. United States team of Mackenzie Kibors, Brogan Williams, and Carly Cochran. There's a score of nine for the United States. Avdeeva was third in the individual World Cup final last year in Lausanne, Switzerland, and won a silver in the mixed team event at last year's FISU World Championships. American side, Brogan Williams. She won a silver as part of the team at the World Archery Indoor Championships in 2014 in Nîmes, France. The Americans in front right now, looking to build on that lead. The Americans will score 56 here in the fourth end, so Russia needs to catch that number. Right now, just trailing the 218 that the Americans have put up, and Russia will do it, scoring 221 overall, 58 in that fourth end to win gold. United States wins silver, and Korea will win a bronze medal. There you see a bit of a rainy day here on day four as we look outside the Nanju Jeollanam-do shooting range in Gwangju. And there's the start list for the men's 25 meter rapid fire pistol. This is the qualification round. It'll go in two stages. Stage one goes today on day four. Stage two of qualification will go tomorrow morning on day five, with the final following after that. The top six from the qualification stages will move on to that final in the afternoon of day five. We're taking a look at four different athletes right now. You just saw there from Qatar, Mohammed Ahmad. Also in this group, David Wilkinson of the United States. He attends the Citadel, the Military College of South Carolina. Anthony Giancarli, also of the U.S. He attends the U.S. Naval Academy. And then Andrei Shapetnikov of Russia. He's a former European junior silver medalist. The two leaders following this initial stage of qualifying, Chen Keihan of China. He was third at a World Cup event in Fort Benning in the U.S. earlier this year. And then Damian Klimek of Poland, who was 68th last year in competing at the Senior World Championships. We get a close-up of the targets that they are aiming at. 10 points if they land right in the middle. And there you see the top six through the first stage of qualifying in the men's 25-meter pistol.